Hello everyone, this is Hoda Ganji and this is the 8th video of the parametric design series. So far we learned about using an attractor point to create a pattern. In this video we're gonna see how it would look like if we use a line as an attractor geometry. So you remember we set up a grid, we had an attractor point, and then we got the distance and we divided that by some large number, so the radius would be a bit smaller. This time, on this part, rather than an attractor point, we're gonna create an attractor line. Okay, so that's the point. You can see it over there. Basically, for creating a line, we need two points. So I'm gonna Control-C and Control-V this one in here. And I'm gonna name this node as attractor point 1, and this will be point attractor 2. The two of them will form a line. So if we want the line to be a straight line, we can keep either the x or the y of the two points to be the same and only change one of the x and y points. So I'm gonna copy and paste one of these attractors and I'm gonna name this attractor y for the second point. And this is gonna be attractor y for the first point. So I'm gonna keep the x of the two points to be the same, but the y would be different. I'm gonna connect this y to the second point and I'm going to change it and I'm going to move this to this side. So now we're going to have an attractor line. All I need to do is to create a line based on these two attractor points. We can type line. We have line by start and end point. And you see there are two inputs, two points as inputs. This is a good one. I'm gonna use this line. I'm gonna attach this point to this point and this point to end point. And I'm gonna rename this as line attractor or attractor line. Okay, now how about I attach this one to other, because now I want to use this line as an attractor. Now you see if I change the location of the line is gonna work as an attractor. I can move this a little bit up. Now the attractor group needs to be updated because now all these items are attractors. So I'm gonna ungroup this. I'm gonna select this part. Seems good. I'm gonna create a group as an attractor. Okay. And if you only want to have the surface patch, you can hide anything that you don't need, such as this line, such as even the grid, we don't need it. Even the circles can go. We can just keep the final outcome. And these two points can also be hidden. If I switch to this mode, you can see the pattern here. Next thing to do is to create some cylinders or some 3D geometries using these 2D patterns. If I go back to geometry, curves, curve icon here, and scroll down, there should be extrude items here. Yeah, they're here. Or you can simply type extrude. What we want to extrude is the curves. So this one seems good it's going to extrude a curve in the normal vector direction, and it only needs one curve or a set of curves and distance as the thickness. That's good. I'm going to select that one. This time we don't need to patch the surfaces anymore, but we want to create some solids. I'm going to delete this one. And you see, these are not capped. Okay, what I can do is that I can find a node which will give me a capped set of solids. And it's actually this one. Curve must be closed. Extrude a curve in the normal direction. This seems like it's going to cap the object. So see how it's different. Yes. So I can get rid of that one. That one will not cap the object, so I would prefer to go with this one, unless that other thing is what you're looking for. Okay. Another thing we can do is that we can assign different values to the amount of thickness of each cylinder. And we can actually relate that to our attractor. So the further the cylinders are from the attractor point, they're going to be higher and the other way around, right? So let's try that. For now, you can see the distance is on 1 by default, right? You can just set a different number right here. For instance, if I say 0.1, because it's in meters, it's going to mean it will be a centimeter. And if I assign 0.01 to the distance, is going to be extruded only by 1 centimeter. Notice that if you put 0.01, it's not going to work. You definitely need to put the 0 before the point so it knows that it's a number. That's how it works in Dynamo. So here we have a set of numbers here, which as you remember is related to the distance between the grid and the attractor point. Let's see what are these numbers. Okay, we have some small values here. How about I use the same set of numbers for the distance, which means for the amount of the thickness of each cylinder. So I'm going to connect this to that, and I'm going to delete this one. So now, not only the radius of the cylinder, but also its thickness or the amount of extrusion is related to how far it is from the attractor line. If you want to make it more complicated, you can also add one more math function. For instance, if I go with one more division, I can divide this number by some other number, maybe 5. And connect this to the distance. We can try like other numbers, 2, 3 or something. So now it is still related to that distance, but it's not tremendously different. This might make a more elegant geometry depending on what you're looking for.